Hey guys, today let's take a look at the planet corner in Coral Castle. The northeast corner is the most fascinating and the most photographed area of Coral Castle. Ed referred to this corner as the planet corner. At the point where the north wall meets the east wall, one large spherical stone sits majestically. Ed himself called it the Mars statue, eliminating any doubt about what it stands for. Ed has also carved planet Saturn right next to it. There is no doubt that it represents Saturn because Ed has carved a ring around it to mimic the real planet. Each of these stones weighs around 18 tons. But as we look at the other objects in the planet corner, things start to get confusing. Ed has carved a huge crescent moon next to Saturn. Moon is not a planet, so what is it doing in the planet corner? But Ed didn't stop there. He has carved another smaller crescent next to it. Why did Ed carve only two planets and leave the rest of them? Why did he carve two crescent moons next to the planets? This is mind-boggling, so I began searching for the answer. To my disappointment, none of the books about Coral Castle explain this weird alignment. However, I noticed the term Crescent of the East referring to the Big Crescent in two documents. One is the information printed on the back of Ed's book, A Book in Every Home. The second was the official tour brochure of Coral Castle. Both were from the office of Coral Castle itself. You can also see the same term in newspaper articles as well. I had never heard of the phrase Crescent of the East, so I called up their office. They clarified that Ed always referred to the Big Crescent as the Crescent of the East, but no one knew what it meant. At least I found out what Ed really called the Big Crescent. Armed with this important clue, I learned that planet Venus always appears as a crescent, not just with the telescope, but you can even see it as a crescent with your naked eye. Also, Venus is best seen in the east just before sunrise. This is why Ed called it the Crescent of the East. So the large 23-ton crescent represents planet Venus. But what about the small crescent right next to it? This represents planet Mercury, because even Mercury always appears as a crescent. On occasions where you can see both planets in the night sky, Venus appears as a bigger crescent and Mercury as the smaller crescent. This view is accurately reflected by Ed's carvings, where you can see the bigger Venus and the smaller Mercury carved side by side. Now, why do we Earthlings see Mercury and Venus as crescents and other planets as spheres? Because only these two planets have smaller orbits than the Earth's. So each of these two planets' surface reflects different amounts of sunlight, revealing different portions of the planet's surface. This is the same reason why we see the moon as a crescent most of the time. All other planets, like Mars, for example, have larger orbits than the Earth's, so we see them as full spheres and not as crescents. However, if you travel to a much farther planet like Saturn and then look at Mars, it will appear as a crescent too. But why did Ed carve just four planets and leave the rest of them? You can find the answer in my book, Coral Castle, Everything You Know Is Wrong. You'll find lots of interesting information like this. I hope you like this video. I'm Praveen Mohan. Thanks a lot for watching. Don't forget to subscribe, and I'll talk to you soon. Bye.